much for joining me on Being Indispensable. My name's Liz Van Vliet. We're all dispensable. I know that better than anyone. I'm a breast cancer survivor. But that doesn't mean that we can't invest in ourselves to improve the skills and capabilities that are going to help us stand out and be perceived as indispensable. Indispensable is also about the being side of the equation. Because if we're not looking after ourselves and our own well-being, then we have no hope of showing up as indispensable in the workplace. Hello, lovely listener. Welcome to episode 63 of Being Indispensable. Well, this week's episode is a being episode, which is quite timely because I'm not even going to tell you what date it is. Clearly, you will see from my episodes that consistency is not a word that can be used to describe my podcasting efforts thus far into 2018. And I am totally owning that. Because much as I love podcasting, I always knew that 2018 was going to be a very, very hectic year. And if you go back and listen to my episodes from the start of this year, you will get a recap on why that was. And in 25 words or less, that would be because I have a daughter who turned 18 last week. And is just getting to the pointy end of her final year of high school, the big year. Doesn't matter where you are in the world, there's always, doesn't matter what they call it. In Australia, it's called your HSC. And, oh boy, it's been a roller coaster. But we're getting to the pointy end of it. Which basically means that she's just gotten through what we call trials and we're a couple of weeks away from officially graduating, and then they go on another few weeks of holidays before their final exams commence. So, look, all I can say is that I committed at the end of last year that I wanted to be fully available for her. I did not want her to feel that I was not available for her this year. I wanted her to feel that when she needed me, I was going to be here for her. And that meant that I knew that I would be stepping back from some things. And one of the big things has been my conference schedule this year in terms of conferences that I've spoken at has been quite small. But on the plus side, I've actually managed to do some paid speaking gigs, as you know, which has been very exciting. And I have been very selective in choosing when I'm going to be focusing on work and making sure that I'm not overwhelming myself so that she can't get my full attention at those times when she's needed it. And that's, you know, I'm pleased to say that I've been able to deliver on that promise to her. She's a wonderful girl. I adore her. And if you've listened to this podcast for long enough, you will know how much I adore my little three little cats, I call them, Kate, Abby, and Tessa. And she is a credit to Mike and I, and she's a credit to herself for the way she's handled things this year. And, you know, one of the things that's come up for her this year is actually the fact that she's in year 12, and when she started year 7, it was during year 7 that I was diagnosed with breast cancer. So for her, her high school years have really been bookended by me, well, my breast cancer experience and where I've been on that in that experience. And I'm really pleased to say that she's seeing me right now in 2018. I refer to it as I'm well and truly on Survivor Highway, because if you've been listening to the podcast, you'll know that I've got a book that I'm working on. And in that book, I talk about my road tripping to breast cancerville metaphor, which is the overarching metaphor. And I talk about, you know, treatment highway when I was going through all of the stuff that I went through with my chemo and surgery. Then I went on to recovery highway, which was quite a potholed little stretch of road. And this year, I can really honestly say that I have really, really felt like I'm well and truly on Survivor Highway. And Kate has been able to witness that. She's witnessed me, you know, she's been in the back seat as I write in the book. She's had the view from the back seat. But it's been really wonderful for her to see that, you know, my word for 2018, for example, which has been, as you know, strengthen. You know, and I meant that in all senses, not just physically strengthen, but to be, you know, to become stronger. Actually, was it strengthen or stronger? Now I'm having a mind blank. Anyway, it's all pretty much of a muchness. I've gotten stronger this year, and she's seen that. And it's really been, you know, the timing has been, in some ways, it couldn't have been better, because we're closing one door and we're opening another for her in terms of, you know, where she, you know, goes on in the rest of her life beyond high school. And she's seeing that she's closing that door with me in a good space, physically, mentally, and emotionally. And that makes me really, really happy. So my episode this week is just to give you that little update that, you know, I apologize for not bringing out episodes as frequently as I would like, but I, you know, I'm fully owning the fact that the podcast is not my number one priority, nor is the business, you know, that I've grown out of the podcast in terms of speaking and training. It's continuing to bubble along, but my focus has been on Kate and being there for her. And, you know, I'm going to look back on this year and feel really pleased that I made that commitment, and I've, you know, I've stuck by that commitment. And it's obviously, you know, has consequences in terms of my income. But, you know, I have never seen this journey as something that was, you know, how do I put this? Money has never been the priority for me with being indispensable. The fact that I've done this podcast with no sponsors for 2 years now, and, you know, that means I've paid for it all out of my own pocket, that tells you pretty clearly that money's not my object. But I feel really good about where we are in 2018, coming into September and the pointy end of HSC. And I will look forward to bringing you updates on her as she goes through those exams and graduates. And if you follow me on Instagram, you'll get to enjoy the photos, because I love sharing my photos. Anyway, I hope everything is well in your life, and I love hearing from you. So please feel free to drop me a message and let me know how you're tracking. Look forward to bringing you my next episode, which is all about a coaching experience that I've had this year. I wanted to bring you some learnings and things that I have been able to impart to this particular person, and I wanted to share them with you guys, because, you know, they're tips that I think you can apply in the same way as this particular little executive assistant has been able to apply them and seen the benefits. So thanks for listening, and have a great week. Ooh. for listening to today's show. I hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to see the show notes, head over to my website. It would be great if you haven't already done so. If you enjoyed the show, if you could kindly go to iTunes and leave a review. It helps other people find the show. Thanks for listening and have a great week.